It is October, but will we be getting a new Mac Mini M1X October announcement as the next Apple event? Well, today I'm going to cover this, if it's likely to be the case, and also want to give you more details about the M1X chipset and when the Apple Mac Mini M1X release date and price is going to be. Hi, it's Matt here. So Apple updated the baseline Mac Mini in 2020 with the M1 chipset inside. However, Apple still continue to sell the top range Mac Mini, and I'll explain why this is later on in this video. However, for design wise, we haven't actually seen a true redesign to this Mac since 2010, when we went from the kind of plastic design to the full on unibody metal design that we can see here. Shortly after, we had changes like the loss of the CD-DVD drive, then in 2018 we also got a space grey version. However, overall the design has remained the same for about 10 years now. The great news is, Apple are looking to make a whole new design for the Mac Mini based on the renders that you're seeing right here, and also Apple will be putting in a more powerful Apple Silicon chip than the M1 that we currently have right now. So going forwards, for all the new Mac Mini videos like this one, I'm going to be first of all talking about specific features and also maybe talking about some of the latest leaks about those features. Then afterwards I'll talk about the planned release date time, and then also we'll also discuss the prices, and we'll be doing this by doing a summary of everything we know about the Mac Mini and also everything else that we've learned in previous leaks. Afterwards I'll be revealing my wish list for the next Mac Mini, and also put in the comments below of what features you'd love to see in the latest Mac Mini, and in my next video I may feature your comment and also discuss my thoughts around it. So let's start then with the expected chipset to be put inside the new Mac Mini. Well, first of all, we have to understand that Apple still sell the Intel more expensive Mac Mini right now. Now, the reason behind this is when everything was still Intel based Macs, this more expensive Mac Mini was considered to be in the next tier of Apple devices in performance. What I mean by this is, with the 13-inch MacBook Pro for example, only the lower tier Pro models got the upgrade to M1, then the higher tier MacBook Pro is still on sale right now, but that does have an Intel chipset inside it, but also does have 4x USB-C ports and is more regarded as the more powerful 13-inch MacBook Pro. But this will be replaced by the new 14-inch MacBook Pro, but the current M1 Pro 13-inch will still be on sale after this. The same as already mentioned with the Mac Mini, the higher tier Mac Mini is still for sale and will be boosted up in performance with the newer chipset, but the M1 Mac Mini will still stay. That new chipset expected to go inside the more powerful MacBook Pro 14-inch and also the Mac Mini is the M1X chipset. From a report by Mark Gurman, he has reported that the new M1X is to be a 10-core CPU and a 16-core to 32-core GPU compared to the 8-core CPU and 8-core GPU that we have in M1. It could feature 256 execution units rather than the M1's 128, and may be able to drive 3 monitors at the same time. It's been rumored that the 10-core CPU would have 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores on top. At the end of the day, by buying this next tier of Mac Mini, it's more designed for professional creators and developers, so to have less efficiency cores, it would be better to be like this, due to the type of users who will be using this Mac Mini. So a quick note, with any of these leaks, even up to the new Mac Mini release date, that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they will come true, and that with the new Mac Mini, I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the next Mac Mini anyway. With that out of the way, here's a quick word from our sponsor for just 1 minute, and then after we're going to be talking about the release date, the summary of everything we know so far, and also the price of the Mac Mini. So guys, really good news. We've hit over 260,000 subscribers. So I'm going to be revealing of the winner of this brand new iPad Pro to one lucky subscriber very, very soon. But just quickly, something I wanted to mention was, sadly, on this community and also on my videos, there are some scammers out there who are pretending to be me. They have names very similar to myself, or for example, they tell you to WhatsApp them with a phone number, as you can see some of these comments right here. I want to tell you right now, this is not me. And the best way you can check to see if it's me or not is to actually click onto the person's profile and see how many subscribers they've got. As I've just spoken about, this channel has just got over 260,000 subscribers. So if you can see that the person's only got like 3 or 4 subscribers, then you know it's definitely not me who is sending you those messages. As I have said multiple times in my videos, I'm only doing the giveaway when we hit a target amount of subscribers. So like 260,000 subscribers. So very soon I will be picking the winner. But if you do come across any of these scammers, just ignore them for the time being. And in my actual giveaway video, I'm going to be showing you a way how to get rid of those scammers altogether and help make this channel an even better community. But do stay posted, guys. I am going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. But if you haven't yet entered, you can still enter right now. And all I want to know from you guys to get your hands possibly on this iPad Pro is basically, what Apple gear are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what Apple gear have you already bought in 2021? Write it down in the comments below, and like I said, very, very soon, I'm going to be picking a winner. And you'll know it's me, because if you click on my profile, there'll be 260,000 plus subscribers to actually be picking that person. So keep an eye out, I will be picking very soon. Let's go back to the video though. So release day. Now follow me with this. We've been told that the MacBook Pro 14 and 16 inch models are planned for release by the end of 2021. It's expected that the new Mac Mini would launch near the same time, as the chipset inside at the moment, referred to as the M1X, will be launching alongside these MacBooks. We've also had leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is likely to come out in 2022 and have the next generation M2 inside with a similar core count to M1. Based on the M1X as an advancement of M1, we believe Apple would not want to launch an M1X Mac Mini alongside an M2 model early next year. So logically, it's assumed that the M1X Mac Mini will come out before the end of 2021 at one of Apple's Mac events. However, the moment we hear any more news about this of the release date, I'll be updating these videos with everything we know. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2021 Mac Mini is expected to give us and the price. So as I've already said, a lot of these features and specs are subject to change. But one thing we do know, most likely what is going to happen with the new Mac Mini M1X, is we're going to be getting a brand new design, as you've been watching in these renders here. It's going to be a slimmer Mac Mini, and also one of the big top features is it's going to have that new MagSafe power connector on the back, similar to the 24 inch iMac that we have right now, which just pops straight out. So that is really, really cool. On top of that as well, inside this Mac Mini, we're going to have the ability to choose from 512 to 8 terabytes of SSD storage. So just to make that clear, that's 512 gigabytes, 1 terabyte, 2 terabytes, 4 terabytes, and 8 terabytes of storage. Then on top of that as well, it will have that brand new M1X chipset inside it, and this will come with 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores. We're also expecting this chipset to appear in the likes of the new MacBook Pros and also that brand new 32 inch iMac or iMac Pro. Then also for GPU, we're expecting either 16 or a 32 core GPU option built right into the M1X, and that will reflect on the amount of RAM that you pick for the Mac Mini. And talk about RAM, there's going to be a choice between 16GB to 64GB of RAM. It's most likely if you choose the bottom range, you'll get that 16 core GPU, but if you pick the higher range, you'll probably get that 32 core GPU. But this hasn't been 100% confirmed yet, but the second it will be, we will update the sheet accordingly. Also with that design, what I talked about, we're going to be getting an aluminium body frame around the edges, what's going to look really, really cool again, just like we have with the current Mac Mini. And then for ports on the back, we're going to be getting 4x Thunderbolt 4 ports, and we're also going to be getting 2x USB 3.2 ports, the usual sort of USB-A design that we get right now, or the usual USB type of ports. And then also there will be a 10GB Ethernet, and then there will also be a HDMI port that will support HDMI 2.1. The starting price for this Mac Mini M1X will start at $1,099, and that will give you a 512GB storage option and also 16GB of RAM. Because you can flick and change the amount of storage and RAM and everything else like that, I can't put all the different prices down here, just basically the starting price. But moving on, let's talk about my wishes for the Mac Mini, and my wish is to do with the price. Right now, the M1 Mac Mini starts at $699, but the Intel version, the more higher spec one, starts at $1,099. My fear is Apple may raise the price of this Mac Mini due to the power you get inside the potential M1X. However, I'm hoping that Apple will retain the price or even better drop the Mac Mini down to $999, as the M1 Mac Mini was actually $100 cheaper than its older Intel brother in the last generation. However, with a new design and everything, I do not believe this will happen with the higher spec Mac Mini. But those are my thoughts, and it is also my current wish for this new Mini. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with this, and also write in the comments below what your wishes would be for the new machine. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon.